Blocks are 2D objects that are included in AutoCAD libraries and can be found if we open the Design Center. Those objects are illustrations of several items such as furniture, electronics, plants, symbols, and many more. We can use them to add more detail in our drawings. As you can see, a simple floor plan has been created and some furniture blocks have already been inserted. Now we are going to add some more furniture in the empty room on the right. We can open the Design Center from the Tools menu if we move the cursor to Palettes and from the available options click on Design Center. Or we can go to the View tab in the Palettes panel and click on the Design Center icon. Alternatively, we can just type the phrase Design Center in the command line and press Enter. Either way, the Design Center opens and we have to follow the right path in order to find all the available blocks. I suggest that you write down this path so it's easier for you to remember where to find them. Back to the Design Center, as you can see, there is a folder list on the left of the window. I will go up to the start of the list and notice that the first folder is Desktop. Under the Desktop folder, there is this PC folder with a plus icon next to it. I'm going to click on this icon to expand the list which contains the subfolders. As you can see, the folder Local Disk appears with several subfolders of its own. From those, I'm going to expand the Program File subfolder. From Program File subfolders, I will select to expand the Autodesk folder, and then I will move down until I find the subfolder of AutoCAD 20023, which is the version of AutoCAD I am currently using. Down to the list of AutoCAD 2023 subfolders, I will search and expand the sample folder. From there, I will go to the English-US folder, and from the two subfolders it contains, I will expand the Design Center folder. Now we can see all the categories of blocks that have been installed along with the application. We can see the categories of blocks there too. I will double-click on the Home category and then double-click again on the Blocks icon. All the available blocks of this specific category appear and I can insert any of them by clicking and dragging it in the drawing area. However, as you can see, the bed I just inserted that way needs further modification. Firstly, it needs to be moved to the right place. Secondly, it has to be rotated. And thirdly, I want to change its size. Of course, I can do those things after the insertion using the appropriate tools. However, I can also do those things before I insert the block in the drawing area. Instead of clicking and dragging the block, this time I will double-click on it. The dialog window Insert opens and from there I can specify the insertion point, the scale, and also the rotation of the object. The insertion point defines the position where the block will be placed based on the coordinate system's origin. If the checkbox Specify on screen is checked, as it is in the insertion point option right now, I am going to be asked to define this specific option after this dialog window closes. In this example, I will leave this checkbox active because I'm not going to define the position of the bed by specifying its coordinates. And most of the times, specifying the coordinates of a block's position is not so practical, so it's pretty common to leave this checkbox active. The scale defines the size of the object. Scaling an object proportionally means multiplying every linear dimension of it by the same factor. For instance, I could insert the bed double-sized by setting the values of the X, Y, and Z fields as 2. When I set the same value in all three fields, the size of the object increases or reduces proportionally in all three directions. However, I could scale the bed in one direction by changing the value of one field and leaving the rest set as 1. In case I want to scale the object proportionally, it's easier to do so if the Uniform Scale checkbox is active. Notice that now only the X field is active. When I change the value in this field, setting it as 1.2 for example, the other two fields update automatically. This means that the bed will be 1.2 times bigger than its original size. Rotation defines the angle at which the object is inserted. In this example, I will set the angle at 180 degrees. Last but not least, I want you to take a look at the Explode option in the lower left corner of the window. With this checkbox active, the bed will be inserted as a set of individual objects such as lines, rectangles, arcs, and so on. If you want the block to be inserted as one single object, do not activate this checkbox. At this point, I will click OK and see what happens. Notice that the second bed I inserted is a little bigger than the first one, and the pillows are now in the opposite side. Furthermore, it is moving along with my cursor since its position has not been defined yet. If I want to move the upper side of the bed, where the pillows are, on the inner side of the window, I have to open the snaps list and check the nearest snap. This snap is represented by a symbol that resembles an hourglass and ensures me that the point of the bed that is gripped on the cursor will be placed on the line of the inner side of the window. So, with this snap active, I'm going to click on a random point on the inner side of the window to place the bed. As you can see, the bed now is placed. Since the design center is still open, I can continue inserting blocks. I can click on the back icon in the upper left corner twice and choose a different category to find another item I want. When I no longer need this window to appear, I will click the X symbol in the upper left corner and close it. Before we finish the lesson, I should mention that all blocks have an insertion point. So, if for example I need to move the first bed I inserted, I can select it, activate the Move command, and before specifying the base point, I will open the snaps list and enable the insertion snap. Then, I will move the cursor on the bed, and once the insertion snap symbol appears, I will click on it to define the base point. Lastly, I will move the bed to the other bedroom.